Hi, and welcome back to our masterclass on data governance with AWS. I'm Kevin Lewis, and to this point, we've been talking a lot about data governance strategy, people, process, you know, all of the things that are necessary to get a program off the ground and to sustain it. I'd also like to talk a little bit about the supporting technology that can help accelerate it. And so we talked about a number of areas within data governance and the data management practices that support it. And so it's really important to understand some of the tools that are available to you. So we at AWS have a number of tools that can help support this process. So I'm going to run through a list of those. It is by no means a complete list. And we also have a partner community that can help with the full range of data governance capability with all of the capabilities we talked about. But to give you a few examples, so first we have Amazon Data Zone, and this is a data catalog that can help data producers contribute to their data to a data catalog, and it will help the end user community find the data they're looking for within the catalog. So it provides sort of a portal that you can use to share data among producers and consumers and make it easy to access and find the data that's needed, both in for analytics and for application development. Also, AWS Glue. So this covers things like data integration. So if I'm pulling data from multiple sources, I can minimize manual coding, but it also includes information and capabilities around data quality management. So data profiling, you know, data quality rules management, things that help you with the ongoing observation and improvement of data quality over time. And then in the area of security and privacy, there are many capabilities. One such example is Amazon Macie. So this can help you scan across your data and look for sensitive information, such as personally identifiable information. But you can also enter your own attributes of sensitive information, and it can help find that sensitive data wherever it lives in your cloud ecosystem. And then we have AWS Lake Formation. So this helps to build data lakes around S3 and helps you with access rights. And it can do things like tag-based access control. So we can mark objects within the data lake associated with particular business areas or data domains. And then it can also do things like fine-grained access control at the column level and the row level. Also Amazon QuickSight. So QuickSight itself, in order to build things like dashboards and reports, it has capabilities to do some transformation of data into those dashboards. But in addition, you can use QuickSight directly for some sophisticated monitoring of data quality issues. So just like you're using QuickSight to create dashboards around business use cases, one of those can be monitoring the data quality itself. So you can use QuickSight to create dashboards to help you monitor data quality and visualize any issues that you find. And in the area of artificial intelligence and machine learning, we have Amazon SageMaker to help you build and deploy models into production. And within generative AI, SageMaker offers a library of third-party models that are available through SageMaker. And specifically, we have Amazon Bedrock for generative AI. And so Amazon Bedrock provides access to third-party generative AI models as well as Amazon's own Titan models. And one of the benefits of Bedrock is that you can keep your internal data private. So we make sure that as you are feeding models for customization and fine tuning with your own data, that data can be locked into your own environment and not used as a basis for training the foundation model itself. And you can do also interesting things to monitor the output. We talked about looking for things like toxicity and bias. You can use things like Amazon Comprehend to look for sentiment analysis. So in much the same way you would look at text data to look for toxicity issues in general, you can look at the output of generative AI models through a tool like Comprehend to make sure that the output of the models is within your guidelines. Also, there's tools like Amazon Recognition so that you can monitor output of images, and you can look for any issues as it relates to images that get created. So there's, again, a wide variety of tools that are available. That's just a small list. Also, again, the partner ecosystem can help you cover every aspect of data governance and machine learning. Okay, so we've covered a lot of ground. And so let's try to summarize a little bit of, you know, what can you do on Monday? What can you do to get started with all of the things that we've talked about? Well, it'll be no surprise at this point that I'll say the first thing to do is to identify some targeted business initiatives, whether that's within the AIML space or whether it's targeting packaged applications that are being delivered. Any major initiative that's funded, that's somebody else's, within somebody else's organization outside of the data team, then you can position data governance to support those other programs. That's where to start. So identify at least one major business initiative to support. Then take a look at the underlying data that's needed to support that initiative. So what is the condition of that data? What kind of issues do you know about that need to be addressed? Position data governance to support and ensure that that data is ready and in a condition necessary for that business initiative to be successful. And then again, prioritize the people part of it, where, you know, which data stewards are you going to assign to which data domains and which data owners need to be in place. Because we've targeted specific business initiatives, we understand the data that's needed to support it. We understand the data issues that need to be addressed. That's when we can figure out how to take people and data management capabilities, put them together and plan them out specifically to support near-term initiatives. And again, with every step, you're going to do two things. You're going to deliver near-term business value in small scope efforts, but you're also going to build your capability over time. And so every project is going to contribute to the maturity of your data governance capability while you're also delivering near-term business value.